Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 26 Beta 6. iOS 26 Beta 6 is available to developers, and iOS 26 Public Beta 3 will be out by the time you're watching this video, or hopefully sometime tomorrow. Last time it took a couple days though. Now this came in at 1.24 gigabytes on my iPhone 16 Pro Max. I did see some people that had it up to 10 gigabytes or so, and along with this, Apple also released many other updates: iPadOS 26 Beta 6, WatchOS 26 Beta 6, along with tvOS, HomePodOS, VisionOS, and macOS updates as well, including older updates with macOS 15.7, RC2, and others. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then we'll go to General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 23A5318C, and this particular build does have some significant updates in it. The first thing is we do have a modem update, so hopefully that improves overall connectivity with cellular data and more. And we also had a hello screen that popped up on the iPhone. On every device I installed it on, it popped up a new hello screen with sort of an onboarding animation. And with iOS 26, you'll see the hello screen here, and it says personalize iPhone with new looks for app icons. We can tap continue. It talks about liquid glass controls on the phone app. And then also if we tap continue, we have access menu options with controls that fluidly morph. And then again, searches within reach and easy to access in apps. It also showed visual intelligence on the 16 Pro Max. So depending on which phone you have, it may be slightly different, but we have a new update just like that on the iPad and Mac as well. Now, after we've passed the hello screen and tapped on get started, the first thing you'll notice right away is how smooth and fast everything is. Apple changed the animation speed and animation look when you're launching apps from the dock. So if I swipe up, go to Mail, go to Safari, you'll see that it swipes out and then swipes back into the app icon. Going into another app opens similarly, but it's super fast overall. And that carries across to non-ProMotion devices as well, such as the iPhone 11. You may not have the smoothness because you don't have ProMotion, but the animation speed is similar. So going into something like YouTube, going back into music, in and out of different apps is just super fast overall. So they've really improved it this time around and it feels much, much better. So just in general, animation seems to be nice and fast throughout. Now we have a few new things to talk about with ringtones. So if we go into settings and then we go down to sound here and haptics. Under sound and haptics, if we go down to ringtone, with beta 5 on the left and beta 6 on the right, you'll see there's a difference here. If we go into reflection, we have more than just one different one. We have a bunch of them now. Default, buoyant, dreamer, pond, pop, reflected, and surge. So let's go ahead and take a listen to those. I'll turn this up a bit, and here's default. Here's buoyant. Here's dreamer. Here's pond. Here's pop. Here's reflected. Here's surge. And we also have one other if we scroll down. We have one called Little Bird. So if we go into that. So that's a new ringtone that you can select along with all the others as well. I think I like Dreamer the most. And I'll leave it on that. Now there's some other changes as well that have to do with liquid glass throughout. For example, the switches in iOS are now different. If we tap on them, they switch to liquid glass back and forth. You can see that here where it bounces before like it didn't before. It just sort of was a switch. Now it has that glass look to it. So I really like that. Not everyone will, but I think it looks good. Also, if we go to the lock screen, if we go to customize the lock screen, you can see there's a difference in liquid glass with the actual clock. It has more of a glass effect to it. And maybe if we make this bigger, you can see it sort of reflects through the overall glass look to it, where it was just sort of a frosted glass look before. So they continue to refine this and make things more glass-like. Also in the wallpaper screen, we're seeing the cancel button. Some people are actually seeing an X here now with a circle. So I'm not showing that, but some people see it as a little different. So depending on what screen you're in. Now, if we go over to another page here, you'll see that widgets are now working properly and again have that liquid glass effect to them. And as I rotate the screen around, I'm not sure if you can see this, but apps, the icons themselves are a little bit more reflective. So you can sort of see a reflection around the top of them and it responds to motion. So they're sort of ramping all of this up in this update. And I think it looks good overall. In beta 5, they actually added a switch called mode switching. So it says classic mode switching, and what that would do was allow you to change the direction of the swipes when you're in camera. For example, you'll see with beta 5 in previous betas, if we swipe, it's sort of backwards from what you would think it should be. Now it sort of matches what you're swiping and there's no option to change it. So you'll see that's what classic mode switching did, but now they've removed the option entirely and just sort of defaulted it back to what it was before with iOS 18. And it makes more sense as we swipe left to right. So again, that's something they've changed and made it a permanent fix. It could change in future updates, but that's what we have now. If we go into messages, there's an update under unknown senders. So if we scroll down to unknown senders, you'll see they've added an option for text message filter. If we go into that, you'll see there's an option for text message filter that's not selected by default. And it says select a filter to automatically sort text messages into categorized lists. You will not receive notifications for messages categorized as spam. So we may see some other filter options here in the future since there's only one and none. Maybe they'll add some in future updates. If we open up a game such as Jetpack Joyride, you'll see game mode on. That's nothing new, but they've changed it back to what it was before, and it's less of a liquid glass icon and just basically game mode in general. If we go into our options here, you'll see game mode is here, and we have a game overlay, of course, where we can use that. We've had that before, but that just gives you an idea that we have additional options, and it may look slightly different. They changed it from, again, more of a liquid glass look back to what it was before. Within accessibility under touch and assistive touch, some are seeing a new icon here. So of course we can customize this, change it to whatever we'd like, but once it's customized, the overall assistive touch icon has been updated for some where it's more of a squared icon like we have with an app icon with a border instead of a round icon. Let me know if it changed for you though. Now, if you're using Xcode, there's a new Xcode preview app icon. So if you're using that connected to an iPhone, you'll see a new icon. And this is thanks to John who sent it to my Telegram group. Now, for those using Apple CarPlay, I did connect it and it connected extremely fast. So that's an improvement and it's using it wirelessly. And changing wallpaper is working properly now. Maps is still a little bit laggy, but overall I didn't notice much of a difference other than maybe alignment changes where it's looking correct now with the time. So some small improvements here just with overall usability, but CarPlay in general has been working fine for me. I know it's not for everyone, but this time around it connected nice and fast. So let me know if it's actually fixed for you as well. And overall, like I said, it has a little bit of lag in maps, but that's the only thing that needs improvement, and hopefully it gets pinched to zoom very soon. There's also a couple of splash screens in this update. The first time you open Photos, you'll see what's new in Photos, updated navigation, more customization for collections, and explore spatial scenes. There's also another one for Notes. So if you go into Notes, you'll see what it looks like here, where it says Notes on Apple Watch, an adaptive toolbar, Markdown export and import. So small changes there, but they continue to refine it, and we'll probably see a lot of those in the RC. As far as anything else, well, bugs and bug fixes, the flickering issue that many had before seems to be fixed for quite a few people, but not everyone. So if you had, maybe you go into a folder, you go back out, open something else, sometimes the screen would flicker, and that seems to be fixed for some people, but again, not everyone is reporting that it's fixed. Also, if you're taking screenshots, it can be problematic. Sometimes it oversaturates it, sometimes it doesn't. Some people have said if you turn off the HDR feature, it fixes it. Not everyone is seeing that though. So for example, if we go into Settings, under General and then Screen Capture, you can then turn off HDR, turn it to SDR. But again, some people are seeing it oversaturate and change, but at least you can share them now. So if you can't share them, turn off HDR. It seems like it will fix the issue. But again, we have that option. If you want to do that, hopefully they'll resolve it in the future. If we take a look at the notes, whether that's in the feedback app or on the public facing website from Apple, we'll go to view release notes, and there's quite a few updates in here. There's 50 groups of resolved issues. What that means is you'll see it says resolved here for general, and this is one group of issues. So many more issues have been fixed this time around, and also 40 groups of known issues remain. So just keep that in mind, such as AirPlay, where auto mix song transitions may not work as expected when streaming with AirPlay. So quite a few things that need to be fixed still, but they're aware of it. If you're having issues, be sure to check this out if you haven't already. See if it's listed here, and if it's not listed, be sure to submit feedback and let Apple know what's going on. Sometimes they'll reach out back to you if it's something they haven't seen and gather more information. As far as anything else, well, releases this time around seem to be on a weekly schedule. For example, we did expect this update probably on Tuesday, but it seemed like Apple decided to go back to Monday releases. So based on that, we could see iOS 26 Beta 7 as soon as next Monday, and then of course iOS 26 Public Beta 4. It's possible we could see an iOS 18.7, but I don't think we'll see that at this point. However, we do expect a macOS 15.7, so probably some security updates and bug fixes, but maybe we'll see an iOS update as well, like we did last year. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 26 Beta 6, I would say if you have to ask, typically you may want to hold off, just keep using iOS 18.6, but if you want to try this out, I would wait for the public beta, as that seems to be pretty stable, especially with this update. And we'll talk about performance and more in just a moment. But I would say if you're concerned about bugs, having issues, poor battery life, and more, I would stay on iOS 18.6, as that's the stable release. With a beta, there always will be issues, but this one seems to be much better, and of course, we'll talk about that more in the weekend follow-up video. As far as overall performance, well, as I showed you already, it seems to be nice and fast. Now, this could slow down over the next week or so. I've seen that in previous updates, so hopefully it stays nice and fast going into things such as the camera, opening different apps, snapping a photo. Everything seems to be quick, but that was a little bit of a delay closing that app. But in general, it seems to be very, very good, especially for a beta. As far as the heat goes, well, it was definitely hot once it reboots. That's pretty typical. It's going to process things in the background for a few days. So if you're having issues maybe with Spotlight, it not working properly, that may be the reason, as it could be indexing in the background. But overall, it seems to be well managed as far as the heat. It's not overly hot or anything like that. When it comes to the battery life, well, I've had pretty terrible battery life on the betas so far, but if we take a look at battery health, I'm at 96% with 292 cycles. And if we take a look at the overall battery usage, you'll see yesterday I had 2 hours and 55 minutes of screen active time, 6 hours and 4 minutes of screen idle time, and used 42% of the battery, or was remaining at 42%. You'll see now I'm at 52%, and it says I'm at 2 hours and 29 minutes of screen active time, 3 hours and 33 minutes of screen idle time. So overall, this looks like I had some odd battery before with 16 hours of idle time, but in general, hopefully I get through a day. It will take a few days to measure this, and we'll talk about this in the weekend follow-up video. As far as storage, well, again, if we go into settings, we'll go back, go into general, and then iPhone storage. We'll take a look at it compared with beta 5. And if we scroll down to the bottom, you'll see iOS on beta 5 for some reason is taking up a huge amount, but that's probably because it already downloaded iOS 26 beta 6. But if we go into it, you'll see that the total size of iOS is 22.41 gigabytes, but it already downloaded beta 6, so that makes sense. Apple Intelligence, though, is taking up less storage this time around on beta 6 with 6.27 gigabytes. iOS is 13.47. So under 20 gigabytes, it's actually better than we've seen in the past. As far as overall benchmarks, I did run them initially, but again, it's processing in the background. You really should wait a day or so, but let's take a look at it. You'll see here under CPU history, it scored 3,293 for single core, 8,268 for multi-core. Again, it's running in the background. It's better than what we had on the weekend, but it seems like it could improve a little bit as we get closer to a public release. So that's everything with iOS 26 Beta 6. If I find any additional features, of course, I'll share that in the weekend follow-up. If there's enough of them, maybe a separate video. But let me know if you found anything else and if you've noticed any changes as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.